One thing that I think characterizes, I guess, millennial generation avant-garde comedy is inaccessibility. If you think of, like, Tim and Eric or Aqua Teen Hunger Force or, say, Between Two Ferns, it all involves this this sense of deep irony that a lot of people seem to have trouble understanding. What do you think it says about the statement of comedy when part of it is to be inaccessible to some?
Very good question. There's two elements to me, good and bad. Here's the bad part, hipper than thou. So there's certainly a premium paid on, you know, getting it when other people don't. The other way to look at it, though, is a quote from Tom Stoppard, who said, "Laughter is the sound of comprehension." The fact is, most comedy, unless it's fart jokes or falling down jokes, requires a degree of intelligence. We talked about how those Saturday night sketches, many people were outraged, taking exactly the opposite lesson from the sketch. The rape sketch was about how men sometimes think that they're not fully responsible, and that's wrong. And yet, they got the exact opposite of that. How dare you say that? So the inaccessibility thing is, I think, very cool. It means you got to work. And when I talk about how to make comedy, and one of the things I always say is you want people to lean forward. You want people to work with you. You don't want to just present them with what it is. You want them to have to figure it out, because when they figure it out, they're more invested. If they're just sitting back and laughing at a fart joke, I do it. It's fun. But it doesn't really engage you. It doesn't pull you in and make you think, which makes you remember it all the more. Inaccessibility, I think, is another way of saying, work with me here. Don't just sit back. So I think it's cool.
Jon Stewart is often asked whether or not he considers himself to be a journalist. And then his response to that is normally that he doesn't. He considers himself to be a comedian first and foremost, and that the journalism just falls from that. And so I was wondering whether you think that people like Jon Stewart and him, Saturday Night Live for that matter, I mean, more recently John Oliver, have a journalistic responsibility with their humor, or a responsibility to at least make jokes that will try to affect social change.
With John Oliver, I don't think there's any question. His show is a soapbox, but it's a well-researched soapbox that involves tremendous amounts of comedy. Jon Stewart has struggled with this for many years, and I think anyone who watches him regularly recognizes that he's transformed a bit. He knows that the vast majority of young people get their news from him, so he feels some responsibility for that. But he doesn't want too much responsibility, and that's why he keeps saying, I'm a comedian, I'm just a comedian. But obviously he does journalism to some degree, and obviously he does muckraking, and obviously he comes from a point of view that he pushes. What he would say is, I'm not taking a political position, I'm against idiots. And when someone says or does something stupid, I'm going to point it out. But that's taking a position. Stupid is not an objective measurement any more than truth and beauty. It's something that we decide in our own brains, and he decides from his perspective, which we would probably characterize as moderately left liberal. And he's using his soapbox. In any case, this is a time like no other in American history when the satirists are running wild, and I love it.